Only the years pass and you think you are already senior to all.
Već senior, like, iznad svih, ali nisi.
But years does not make you a perfect das.
Savršeni sluga.
Only you became a perfect ass.
Potrebno je samo savršen stražnik.
Magarac.
Savršen magarac.
Donkey, a perfect donkey.
Da,
asino. Nothing else. For the Maya's tricks.
Za trikove Maja.
So, Bhakti Yoga is a practical thing.
Bhakti Yoga je praktična stvar.
And also, in institution, they utilize perfectly this Bhakti Yoga to exploit devotees 100%. Exploit,
let's
say. They won't have any time even to read or chant or remember. You see, Bhakti Yoga means you, every day, you remember the leelas of Bhagavan, all day.
Now,
you go to Arati 4 o'clock, 4:30. Good places.
U dobrim mjestima.
Yeah. And then they allow you to chant a little bit,
Samo mantra.
40 minutes class. And out. For collection.
I onda van u skupljenje.
So there you struggle with Maya and your own mind and body. Because especially in Western countries, there's so many attraction.
Zemljama je toliko privlačnosti.
For the woman, male, and for the male, woman. Other thing as well. Enter into your nose certain taste, smell, food, clothes, money, anything. You happen to attract the energy. Different energies. Tamaguna, Rajaguna, Sattvaguna.
Tamaguna, Sattvaguna.
So, how can you, in the middle of the street, we're giving books, remembering Krishna fully, if you are not a fixed
bhakta?
Like some devotees were picturing, they were clever, so picturing Krishna, distributing to Krishna. So they visualize the form of Krishna, so they survive in this environment. But not everybody has that imagination, capacity, able to see Krishna everywhere in every form. So naturally been burned out, or the house got went down. Also mind me disturbed. It's very difficult in the middle of the street to meditate on Krishna when car passing by, pollution, they sit down and chant your rounds, try to concentrate. It's a huge sacrifice. I'm telling you, it's a huge sacrifice that I did myself. And I had to go somewhere else where there was nobody able to chant or even chant my poetry. Or read a few shlokas or try to memorize something or learn something.
It was difficult.
So need an environment, especially in a temple or ashram, where you, for a few hours, able to remember the lila of Krishna. And whatever you heard from your Gurudev, analyze it. And apply your daily activity of service. You see, when you make an offering, you beautifully decorate. You give with great attention, intention, to the divine couple, and then see whether they are satisfying or not. Even you don't see the eat, only the blessed. Because many times it happened that the devotees out of pure love, really, when they come to that stage, after passing Ashakti or come to Ashakti, Bhagavan has come down and eat and disappeared, the food disappeared.
But
that is very rare. That's why I say divine. Because due to bhakti, Bhagavan has taken that food and literally eaten. Not just only we say this is prasad, and I became mad because some devotee who was a mad mentality cooked that food and also eat, and then I also affected by that prasad called prasad. And I don't know what my problem is. Because he was thinking anything else but God.
Možda
bi se neki ludi čovjek skuhati,
da je molio Bogu i kao to je prašat, ti bi trebao to pojesti i jako se dobro osjećate, zapravo je to obični ludjak skuhao.
So it was almost hardly any difference between you buy a car shop, a food or what was cooked by a mad person who has
no razlike da li si kupio u karmi shop.
Only mi stahlo, this is prašat. Ili ti kuhao
ludi
bakta
i servirao kao
prašat,
to ti sve jedno.
Even Prabhupada said, when they burn so many times the prashad, the proper serrator, is it using everything as prashad? Back into your consideration?
On Prabhupada rekao, zar misli da je sve prashad, što je
popio, zar ti misli da je popio. What you think is prashad.
Ne mora biti bakta, misli da je prashad.
And it was a perfect example of in Jaipur, Govindaji's Mandir, when one prostitute offered lavishly prashad for Govindaji. And all these Vaishnava Brahmins have taken up to full extent. And then after they have taken, all boils come out of their body. Boils. You know boils? They are suffering like anything. It's what happened. We have taken prashad and only suffering. So one went into meditation and asked Govindaji, why are we suffering now?
And Govindaji said
that this prostitute earns money through sinful activity.
Ali ta prostitutka,
and then he offered me
that
food, that prashad. I can digest pap, but you can't.
Onda neko može to probaviti, ali neko ne može.
You see, I can digest the reaction of this food, but you can't digest.
Znači, božanstvo može.
So you should have taken only a little bit of remnants of it, but not full extent.
Ali običan čovjek ne može, on može pojesti samo mali komadić.
But we say here, everything is offered with prashad.
Mi kažemo sve to što je ponuđeno.
Now my person doesn't change his mind and get angry here or do very harmful things to other Vaishnavas. Because of prashad is so pure. On the accurate their estimation.
Ne naprave zato što je prasadan tako čist.
I'm practical. Maybe I'm a heretic in Vaishnavism. Let it be.
Ja sam možda heretic, ja sam praktičan, ja sam možda heretic.
But Vaishnavism gives me full freedom of speech.
Ali Vaishnavism mi daje potpunu slobodu govora.
Open mindedness.
Otvorenost uma.
And able to express myself.
I način da se izrazim.
And people say that, this is offensive.
Let
it be. I rather sit with Yamaraj, talk about Krishna, than listen to these fearmongers.
Nego slušati.
Fearmonger, you know, fearmonger. That if you speak like that, you go to hell. Yes, I can go to hell. What do people say to me?
Ovi koji strah daje, oni govore o strahu da pritiskaju strahom.
One time I was criticizing a sannyasi who was living double life.
Koji je živio dvostruki život.
Neki štirake. Dobro.
One time we criticizing one sannyasi of living double life.
Vidiš, jedan sannyasi koji žive dvostruki život.
Then, as people said to me, I will ask forgiveness because I will go to hell. But after then they learn about that, yes, what I say is true, they changed.
That
they are blind. They not see the truth, and even they see, they silent. Because it's suitable for them, because maybe he is also doing the same. So he has no right to criticize anyone. No right to speak truth. Only smile nicely, cut a few jokes, and go. And they, he's a nice devotee. He's such a nice class. But what you heard, you remember? No, you don't remember what he said. But he was such a nice person. So we didn't change this much. Of course, I am not GBC or anybody else. But if I say, if I see unjust and untruth, I say something. To some extent. Because even truth also is painful. When Krishna passed away in a terrific, horrible circumstances that his family murdered one another,
we
learn about this painful truth. onda, so when he returned, Yudhishthira didn't say nothing.
Onda,
although he knew what happened.
Onda kad je vidio svu tu tešku istinu, nije došlo.
And silently Yudhishthira nodded his head when Yudhishthira asked, didn't say nothing, that everything is fine.
Onda kad je Yudhishthira pitao, why? Because
he didn't want to hurt the Pandavas,
the
family of extended family of Krishna there.
Nije htio svoju širu obitelj povrijediti, rekao da im kaže tu istinu, zapravo dogodilo.
In Hastinapur, huh? Because truth also can hurt people.
Istina također može povrijediti čovjeka.
So it gives you some time, and they shall learn about the truth.
Treba dati neko
vrijeme. They will experience themselves.
I pusti ljude da sami.
So you waited until the Arjuna came back, and then Yudhishthira immediately understood.
Dok se Arjuna nije vratio, ona je Yudhishthira.
So that's why not necessary all the time to tell the truth.
Huh?
Or rather directly we point out.
Huh?
But also, but I guess actually also all depends on the circumstances.
Huh?